All right, so a few updates. I've been trying to blast through some of the more uninteresting things that I'm working on with the van. I'm doing a lot of finishing touches here and there. For instance, I have these side and front covers for the bench done. I have them glued on. They're not screwed in, so you don't see any nails. But all I had to do is take this material. It's the same material as the ceiling, basically. It's just a different color. I think it's even the same pattern, which I didn't really mean to do, but it's a different color, which I like. But I just took this, kind of cut it out to a rough shape, and then took a pencil and traced where I wanted the cuts and bends and rounded edges to be, and cut it out, and then stuck it on and glued it. Also left a little hole right here, so I have access to these outlets and the switch on the inverter. But I'm pretty happy with this. I think it looks pretty nice. Aside from this, let me show you what else I'm doing. So what I'm hoping to do today is I went and bought this vinyl plank flooring. It has a little bit of weight to it, which I don't like, but I think for the floor, because the feeling of it and the sturdiness of it matters a lot more than like the ceiling. Like the ceiling, it really doesn't matter that it's these kind of weird sheets and that it's not actually planks. But for the floor, I feel like it's a lot more important that it has some kind of heft and that it feels nice at your feet. So I bought these, and I'm planning on taking this gray color and using it in this kind of one-third section of the van that's a slightly lower step, as you see right there. And then there's a different color than I want to do for the rest of the floor down there. So I'm going to keep cutting these. You've seen me cut a lot of wood before if you've been watching, so I'm not going to bother recording me just taking a saw and running it down this. But I think 6 or 7 of these going left to right like this, and this will be covered up. The one thing that's going to be tricky is I'm going to have to cut out holes for these, which might be a little annoying, but I don't think it'll be that bad. I'm hoping this is like a half a day, 3/4 of a day project. And once this is in, I think it's going to look pretty nice. So I'm going to get started on this. Here we are. I am really happy with how this turned out. I think this looks really nice. I like the color that I picked out for this a lot. I think the seams look pretty good. It doesn't look bad or anything. This I plan on doing something about. I'll 3D print some kind of like little cover thing for this or something. This won't look exactly like this when it's all said and done, but even with that, I still think this looks pretty good. So it took me about a day to put all these in because doing these cuts the holes was really annoying and tedious. But in addition to putting these in over the last day or two, I also decided to do a bunch of little things around the van. For instance, I put some wood back here, you can see right there, to push this cabinet out so that it's more in line with the ones down there. I think it looks pretty good now. It's not like sagging or it's not like drooping down. In addition to that, I took these panels behind the sink out and cut them a little bit different. I cut this hole a little bit bigger so that I could put on this frame, whatever you call these, for the outlet. It's sunk in there a little bit, but oh well, it's not a big deal. Maybe sometime in the future, if I really care enough, I'll disassemble this and take the time to figure out how to pull this forward just a little bit, but I really don't care enough to do that right now. So I'm happy with that. I also put in this little panel right here. This came with the inverter. So I can use this to turn on and off the inverter, which the inverter is down there, if you remember. So I don't have to go down there and out of the van to switch on and off the inverter and check the status on and everything. I can control it from here, which is nice. So a bunch of small things done, van's coming together. What I want to do today is I want to take the time to try and mount at least one of the solar panels on the roof of the van. Hopefully that goes smoothly and easily. And I'm thinking I'm gonna plug in one of the solar panels and see how long it takes one of them to charge the batteries. The batteries right now are at 70-ish% charge. So I'm thinking I'll plug in one, charge the batteries, see how long it takes, And if one of those things charges the batteries in a reasonable amount of time, from 70%, then I think I'll just put one up there, not two. Because the panels are a little big. Putting two up there might be awkward. But that's the big goal for today. Other than that, I think I'll probably find small things to do around the van. But progress. Good progress so far. The van's coming together. I shall go get my ladder and get ready to go on top of the van. Okay, check this out. So originally, I was thinking the panels that I bought would be too long, long ways to put perfectly diagonally on the van. I thought they would hang over too much. But looking at this, see how that's like right in line with the top of the van? You can see it, but it's right up there. Well, the other side is the same. So I'm actually thinking this is fine. Like, I don't care if someone can see that really. I think it looks fine. It's not going to be a big deal if people can see up there. I know I cannot put them long ways because these panels are just too long. If I tried to put two end to end, it would stick over like 2 feet. It would be ridiculous. But I like the look of this actually. I was originally thinking I would have to angle them like diagonally because I thought they'd be too long, but I think this looks fine. So now is the annoying part where I think I need to mark holes on the panels, which I grabbed a marker right here. So I'm gonna mark holes on the panels so I can drill out a hole to put a bolt through, which is going to be annoying and tedious. Especially since I don't want to take the panels down. I want to leave them up there because they're kind of heavy. So I'm gonna do that. I think I won't record it because it's gonna be pretty straightforward. Mark hole, drill hole, nothing exciting. So I'll show you when I'm done. Okay, so I have those four holes cut out on the solar panels, and I have them back up aligned where I want to screw them in. Or not screw them in, bolt them in. But before I bolt them in and make them more permanent fixture, I want to plug in that first panel and just see how much power I'm getting out of it, because I'm curious. These should be two 250-watt panels, but when I plugged in the first one initially just to test it, it seemed like I was getting more than that. So I want to plug in just one and see how well it's doing. So before I connect the panels up top, I still need to connect the wires that go up to the roof of the van to the charge controller. So I'm going to do that now. Okay. Feels good. That feels good. Negative, positive. Okay, now I'm going to go to the top of the van and plug in the panels. All right, so I have it plugged in on the inside. So now all I need to do is take these wires that are going down into the van and these wires that are coming out of the panel and plug them in. So this is negative, and this is negative, this is a black wire. Okay, and this is positive, there's a little symbol there, and this is positive, there's red wire down here, so this should do it. I'm going to go look on the inside now. So I didn't hear any pops or sounds that would be bad that would tell me that I did something wrong. If you look at this, see how this shows progress now? This should be charging. It says I'm getting 25.4 volts off of the panel. It says I'm getting 12.9 amps off of the panel, which, okay, 25-ish times 13-ish, that's like, what, 300 watts, something like that. It says I'm at 87% battery now, which is kind of weird. So we are charging. Let me see. 25 volts, 13 amps. Okay, so I'm gonna let this sit here for a few hours and I'm gonna come back and see what it says my batteries are at. Which it's weird. It says the batteries are already at 89%. That's weird. That's pretty weird. I don't know why it says that. Because there's no way it charges that fast. But we'll see. So I'll be back in some time. And in the meantime, I'm going to probably run and grab food. I'm probably not going to start anything new right now. So, cool. Batteries are charging. Pretty exciting. I'll be back.